What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Today we bring back our Spring Boot application and tackle a specific part, a specific file of that app, the controller. This is the part that is exposed to our clients, and while testing the app, we made use of an automatically generated interface with the help of Swagger. But we never actually got to talk about Swagger. What is Swagger UI, and how can we make use of it to visualize and interact with the API's resources without having any of the implementation logic in place? OpenAPI specification, previously known as Swagger specification, describes a standard format for REST APIs. This standard is important so that everyone who writes REST APIs is compliant with its best practices, such as versioning, safety, and error handling. We can say that OpenAPI is like a template with a set of rules and constraints explaining how you could describe an API. So, what is Swagger? If you've built an API from scratch, you've probably questioned if all the necessary information the user will need to be successful was included in its documentation. Swagger saves a lot of time in writing this API documentation, all while helping us follow the OpenAPI guidelines. Let's bring back the latest version of our Spring Boot application, add to it the dependency you see in front of you, and then navigate to the exposed Swagger UI address. The first widely used Swagger annotation is the hidden one. This annotation allows us to hide a property, a field, or an API from the user UI, allowing us to expose certain parts of our app as we see fit. In this first example, after adding the hidden annotation to the description field, it was removed from the example generated by Swagger. However, keep in mind that this still allows us to make use of that field. In the second example you see, we made use of the same annotation to hide the get endpoint itself. Users are now unable to make use of that endpoint via the Swagger interface. The next annotation, and the most widely used one, is the at operation annotation. This annotation allows us to describe our endpoint, hide it, and mark it as deprecated. It also helps us describe the parameters passed to this endpoint and detail the different responses it may return to the user. Look at what the getByTitle endpoint looks like on the Swagger UI before and after we introduced the at operation annotation. Okay, in the first part of this video, we kept mentioning Swagger UI and not simply Swagger. And that's because Swagger API is a set of open source tools and not just the UI built to help programmers develop, design, document, and use REST APIs. These tools are built around the OpenAPI specification, and as of this video, we have three components: Swagger Editor, Swagger UI, and Swagger Code Gen. Swagger Editor has an editor on the left panel where you can plug in all your requests and response data. The editor supports YAML or JSON format. On the right panel, we can view the documentation as the end user will see it. If we have any errors, the live error report will share the row we need to adjust to be compliant with the specifications. To not rewrite a new REST method each time we introduce a new one, we can use the autocomplete option to build our documentation much faster. As an open source tool, Swagger Editor allows others to fully customize documentation to meet their needs and requirements, making it easy to use. Swagger Editor makes it convenient for us to design our specifications before we dive into coding. The editor tells us exactly what the API will ask for, what the request will look like, and what response we can expect. Now that we have our documentation created with our editor, we need a way to share it with our users. Swagger UI displays them as interactive API documentation. It takes the YAML file and converts it into a user-facing documentation that lets your users try out the API calls directly in the browser. Some key features of the UI include: easily integrated, Swagger UI easily integrates with existing and new applications. Flexible setup, Swagger UI can run in several ways such as cloud, locally, node packages, etc. Interactive, Swagger UI has a try it out button that turns the query parameters into fields. This allows us to make a call against an actual API. By using Swagger UI to expose our API's documentation, we can save significant time. It also allows users to effortlessly interact and try out every single operation our API exposes for easy consumption. So far, we've created interactive API documentation with Swagger Editor and Swagger UI. It is now time to implement the server logic so that our API can go live. Swagger Code Gen generates server stubs, client SDKs, and client libraries for an open API specification. Swagger Code Gen gives us many choices of servers or frameworks, such as Go Server, Java Server, Scala Server, and Node Server, allowing us to choose the server that supports our backend implementation. And that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.